Reconocidos líderes políticos y empresariales con los presidentes Santos y Duque a la cabeza estarán en la cumbre Concordia Américas 2018. En tres semanas, Bogotá será la sede de este gran encuentro. Hassan Nazar, usted y su invitado.
Y es un placer tener con nosotros esta mañana a uno de los cofundadores y el CEO de Concordia, una de las entidades más importantes en el continente para el diálogo de política, no solo política pública, sino política regional. Y por eso lo saludamos, Matthew Swift. What a pleasure to be with us this morning. It's really a pleasure.
It's a great pleasure to be in Bogotá.
Well, tell me first of all the dates. When is going to be Concordia in Bogotá?
July 16th and 17th at the Agora Convention Center.
Is an open date? I mean, everyone can get to the meeting?
Everybody can get to the meeting. You just have to sign up. Mm-hmm. So if you go to concordia.net, you can sign up for the summit.
Everything is online.
Everything will be online as well, and we have a great partnership, as you know, with RCN and NTN24.
Of course. One of the main issues is going to be not only the topics that are going to be discussed, but the people that are going to be participating. From Colombia, who is going to be here?
Well, we're very honored that President Santos will be participating. Mm-hmm. He'll be one of our opening speakers, and that will be very important because his administration has been very gracious to Concordia. Mm-hmm. But we are also especially excited that President-elect Duque and Vice-President-elect Ramirez will both be participating at the summit.
Wow.
And both really be mapping out their vision for the next 4 years.
When you see the topics that are going to be discussed, what are going to be the main issues? I understand healthcare is going to be one.
Healthcare is going to be a huge one, right? How do you create a national healthcare program that is also flexible from a local perspective,
okay,
right? That's one of the biggest themes, and our leadership council at Concordia is very eager to touch on that. We'll mm-hmm. also be talking about education.
Education.
Right? What's the future for education in this country? Okay. We need to be thinking about Venezuela, right? The humanitarian crisis. This is an issue that Concordia, that we've covered for a number of years now, and so that will be very important. We got to also talk about politics, right?
Of course.
Have you ever lived through a more fascinating time in politics as a journalist? I find today to be absolutely fascinating because you have no idea what's going to happen next. So we're going to talk about U.S.-Colombia relations.
So
we're
going to talk about politics. Trump is going to be in the agenda?
Absolutely. And it's going to be very important to have a productive conversation about mm-hmm. that, because I think we can all agree that U.S.-Colombian relations are incredibly important. So what is the administration thinking about? What is changing now that we have a new Secretary of State in mm-hmm. Mike Pompeo mm-hmm. as well, who I know is also very passionate about strong relationship between Colombia and the United States.
When you talk about the relationship between Colombia and the United States, security is going to be involved also.
Huge. Security Huge. And I think addressing narco trafficking. I think you cannot have a conversation about security unless you are also talking about narco trafficking. If you look from a U.S. political perspective, this is something that's very, very much top of mind.
Taxes, free trade is going to be involved?
Listen, I've spent a lot of time in Colombia, but I've also spent a lot of time traveling around the world. Colombia needs to be a place that is friendlier for business. We need to think about what is a smart tax plan going forward. And also from a trade perspective, not just with the United States, but with the world. So one thing that Concordia does that I think is different from what other institutions do is we talk about Colombia in context of the world, not just the region.
When you see the region, mm-hmm. right now, if you check any newspaper in the world,
yeah.
maybe the big news in Washington, in New York, is President Trump and the policy of immigration.
Yes.
Is that going to be touched, involved in this summit?
I can see it being touched. For instance, Vice President, former U.S. Vice President Joe Biden, mm-hmm. who will be giving a major speech at this summit. I think this is probably going to be an issue that he will likely touch. You know, he's coming not as an official representative of the U.S. government, but he has incredible experience. He cares deeply about Colombia. You know, that was demonstrated through his entire career, both as a senator and as a vice president. So I think he's going to touch on a wide array of topics, thinking about what does he see as the future of Colombia, but of course factoring in what U.S.-Colombia relations look like. You can't obviously talk about it without thinking about the ramifications of immigration.
Tell us about Concordia. How does it work? The thing that he was in New York, in Washington, how does it work with the region?
So Concordia today, our annual summit, is now the largest summit alongside the UN General Assembly in September in New York. So remember that time
when heads
of state come from around the world and descend upon New York City to talk about the world. Concordia Summit is the largest summit outside of the UN that week. And we bring together over 3,000 leaders from the public and private sectors, representing over 70 countries. But here's the great thing.
It's amazing.
But here's the great thing. Colombia is incredibly well represented at this annual summit. Everybody from people like Carlos Vives, mm-hmm. who presented his foundation and performed at last year's annual summit.
But politicians.
Also, absolutely, but also the incredible support from our very founding of President Uribe. He's on our leadership council in addition to President Pastrana. And we would not have known about Colombia. We would not have been as invested here as we are if it were not for President Uribe, who, interestingly enough, I was introduced to through President-elect Duque years ago.
When he was living in Washington.
When he was living in Washington,
and the other
exactly.
question is, Concordia has also a huge good relationship with President Santos. And the fact that you're going to have both President Santos and President-elect Duque
Absolutely.
On this summit is a huge thing for any guest.
Listen, let me tell you, as an American who's mm-hmm. particularly active also in American politics, a very smooth handoff between administrations is as important as it gets, right? You couldn't have had two different presidents than President Obama and President Trump. Mm-hmm. Yet it was a smooth and respectful and elegant process by which we had a transfer of power. We're going to have the same thing here in Colombia. And if Concordia can play a small part in providing a platform for that, we'll do it.
And I understand Bogota is becoming a very important place also for Concordia.
So here's the thing. We don't come and just host an event and then leave, mm-hmm. right? We want to center all of our Concordia Americas work in Bogota. Mm-hmm. We'd like to open an office here. We'd like to establish an institute here. So we're really hoping that the summit in July will be the catalyst for that.
We're really, really happy to be part of this. And thank you very much, Matthew, for this minute, for this interview. And we hope and we know this is going to be a huge success, not only for Concordia, for Colombia and for the region. Thank you again.
Thank you very much.
Matthew Swift.